Hi, Microbehunter here again. These are onion cells, and each onion cell, if you look carefully, has a bluely stained nucleus. And in this video, I'm going to show you how you can stain the cells of an onion yourself so that you're also able to see those nuclei, because it's a very straightforward and also simple staining procedure. It's a little trick that you have to use to make sure that the ink actually goes into the cells. Yes, we'll be using ink. As a matter of fact, regular fountain pen ink that is water soluble. And I like to use the blue one. And this one, you simply take out from a cartridge, ink cartridge. You do not need more than just a few drops of them. If you actually want to use more of them, then I recommend that you also buy yourself a full ink bottle with this ink. Well, here's our victim that I'm going to be staining. It's the onion, of course. I cut out a little square using a knife, as you can see here. And between the layers of the onion, there is the onion skin. And this onion skin is approximately one cell layer thick. And that's what we'll be using. So I'm simply using my fingernails to carefully peel it off. And this onion skin here, we are going to stain. You need tweezers and you need alcohol, concentrated alcohol that I'm now pouring in there. And beside the ink, also some water to rinse the onion cells from the ink. So first of all, just for a few seconds, you dip the onion into the alcohol. Don't let go with the tweezers, otherwise you're going to have a problem finding it again. And then it goes for a few seconds, maybe about 10 or 15 seconds, into the blue ink. The alcohol removes the water from the cells, and then when you place it into the ink is able to enter the cells. It's the reason why alcohol is so important here, because otherwise the ink won't go into the cells. It's very blue and too much ink probably, so for this reason you quickly briefly rinse it for a very short time in clear water. Don't overdo that, because otherwise the ink is gonna be gone again. And now comes the most difficult part. You somehow have to spread this onion skin. You have to somehow spread this on a slide, which can be a little bit difficult because it likes to stick together. A cover glass goes, of course, on top of it. Everything goes under the microscope. And then if you're lucky, and if all the timing was correct with the staining, you're going to see, of course, the onion cells and also the nuclei, which are all stained blue and much better visible this way than without the staining. So what I'll be doing now is I'll be going into more. I'm going to be zooming in a little bit more. And then we're going to have a look at several of these nuclei, because what I want to show you later on as well is that they are also so-called nucleoli inside the nucleus. As a matter of fact, I was always able to find two of them. Nucleoli are two structures which are a little bit darker stained, and they can be found in each nucleus. That's the place where certain chemical reactions also happen. I think I like quite a lot that the cells were so regularly stained. So that means almost all of the cells actually, the nuclei of almost all of the cells actually accepted the color. So in that sense, it's quite reproducible, this procedure. And it's a very simple lab practical that you can also do with introductory in microscopy courses, for example, with students, and introductory courses of staining, because the chemicals, it's ink. It's pretty safe to use also for children. So now let's zoom in a little bit further, and the cell wall is of course always quite well visible, and in there is always the nucleus. Now look very carefully. Do you see those two dots when I'm focusing back and forth? Well, those two dots inside the nucleus, well, these are the nucleoli, and I think the ink itself seems to associate itself with the chemicals that are in there as well. I think the ink also is able to stain DNA a little bit, because it has certain ring shape aromatic structures which are quite well suitable for staining DNA. So I checked several of these cells, and all of them actually had those two small nucleoli also stained. I was quite happy that the results were that definite and that clear. Even at the first trial, I did not have to have several trials to get these results. It was quite foolproof almost as a method. So we'll be looking at a few more of these cells now. And what I want to do now also is I want to say a big thank you to my supporters. because this YouTube channel and also the other YouTube channels are also possible because of your support. And over the last couple of weeks and months, I have gained several supporters over Patreon and also several over my GoFundMe page, where I'm now saving money together to buy a better microscope so that I can build an image library and also to, of course, improve the videos in this very channel. All of the information can be found in the description. So yes, these are my supporters. A big thank you. And yeah, I'm really grateful that you all have found the channel. And of course, also microscopy is such interesting enough that you're willing to support it. I think I'm just gonna call it quits for right now. There are, of course, a whole bunch of other videos and playlists that I would like to encourage you to visit as well. Yeah, I think I'm just gonna leave it at that. I wish you all the best. Happy microbe hunting, as always. See you around next time, and bye-bye.